Good morning, students. In the last class, we have completed the lesson, Dear Mum. It is a poem from B reading. And I think you have remembered the story of that poem. What is the story about? Yes, it is about a boy who is very naughty, isn't it? The poet says that some naughty children do naughty things both at home and at school. They cover their mistakes or faults cleverly and nicely. In this poem, a naughty boy made mischief when his mother was not at home. When she returned, before her mother's asking him why he had done those things, the boy began to tell his mother the reasons for various happenings in the house during her absence. He said that while she was out, a cup went and broke itself. A crack appeared in the blue vase. He did not turn on the tap, but mysteriously the sink overflowed. He also expressed his surprise on how the cat managed to turn on the washing machine, especially from inside, or how the self-raising floor managed to self-rise. He said he was terribly afraid when a series of muddy footprints appeared on the new white carpet. He said he was not the cause of all these happenings, and that he was good and honest. He said that he thought that the house was haunted by ghosts when he had gone over to his grandmother. So this was the story which we have completed in our last class. So today we are moving to our new lesson, and the name of the lesson is The Emperor's New Clothes. This is from C reading. If you see in your textbook, The Emperor's New Clothes. Many years ago, there was an emperor who was so fond of new clothes that he spent all his money on them. One day, two men came to the emperor's court. "We are weavers," they said. "We can make the most beautiful cloth in the world." The emperor was very happy. So here the story is about an emperor, isn't it? So what they are saying is, many years ago there was an emperor who was so fond of, means like very much, who many years ago there was an emperor who loved new clothes very much, because and he used to spend all his money on those clothes only. So what happened? One day two men came to his court and they said, "We are weavers." And what did they say? "We can make the most beautiful cloth in the world." So when they came to the emperor and they said they are weavers and they can make the most beautiful cloth in the world, so the emperor was very happy. "Our cloth is also very special," said the men. "Only wise men can see it, fools can't." So what did they say? They said that their cloth is very special because only wise men can see the cloth which they have prepared, but not the fools. So that's very good, thought the emperor. When I wear the clothes made with it, I will know who is wise and who is foolish. So when they said that their cloth is very special, and when they means what did they say? That cloth only wise men can see, and the foolish men can't see the cloth. So like that the weavers has told to the emperor. So listening those words, what did emperor thought? It is, that's very good, because he was thinking, if I wear those clothes, then I will know who is wise and who is foolish. Foolish means person having no knowledge or wisdom. The emperor gave the men a lot of money. Start weaving at once, he told them. They set up two looms and pretended to be very busy, though they had nothing at all on the looms. They asked for the finest silk and the purest gold thread. They put these in their own bags and they worked at the empty looms until late at night. So what happened? The emperor has given them lot of money and they have told them, and he have told them to start weaving. So they set up two looms. Looms means a machine for weaving, and pretended, what did they do? They were acting as if they are weaving the cloth, but they actually, there is nothing to loom on that, on that machine. So, and also what did they do? They asked for finest silk and also the purest gold thread. So all those things which they have asked the king has given them. So all those things they took and they kept it in the bag, and they worked at the empty. Empty means nothing. Empty looms. They worked at the empty looms. Loom means, I told you, a machine for weaving. So they were pretending, isn't it? So as they are pretending that they are weaving, and the finest silk and the gold thread which they took from the king, they have kept it in their bag, and they were pretending to work on the empty looms until late night. I should like to know how those weavers are getting on with my cloth, thought the emperor. Only wise men can see the cloth. I'll send my old minister, who is the wisest man in the court. So the good old minister went into the room in which the men were working at the empty looms. What can be the meaning of this? Thought the old man, opening his eyes very wide. I cannot see anything on the looms. So what happened? So the king, the emperor was thinking that he should know, means I should like to know how those weavers are getting on with my clothes. So the emperor thought that he want to know that how those weavers are weaving the cloth for the king. So what did the king thought? Only wise men can see the cloth. So he sent his old minister, who is the wisest man in the court. So the good old minister, so he went into the room in which the men were working, and he saw the empty looms, and he didn't understood that what is the meaning of this, because he didn't see the cloth on that loom. So he was thinking, what is this happening? And he tried, means he still widened his eyes and he was observing whether the cloth is there on the loom or not. So, and he was thinking that I cannot see anything on the loom. So, because they were pretending, but what did they told? Only wise men can see, whereas the foolish men can't see. But this minister is the wisest man in the court, but he also can't see the cloth on the looms. Come a little nearer, said the men to the minister. Isn't the cloth beautiful? So those men who was pretending to work on the empty looms, What did he one of the men told to the minister to come closer and see whether the cloth is beautiful or not. They pointed to the empty looms. The poor old minister looked hard. He could see nothing on the looms, for nothing was there. So they were asking the minister whether the cloth is beautiful or not. Means pointing their finger to the empty looms, they were asking whether the cloth is beautiful or not. The poor old minister, he was trying to find the cloth on the machine, but he could not see nothing on the loom as they are empty. What, he thought, is it possible that I am a fool? Well, sir, said one of the men, how do you like the cloth? So when they have shown him the empty looms, he was thinking, what? And he was thinking that, is it possible that I am a fool? So he's thinking to himself that, am I a fool? Because I can't see the cloth on the machine. So am I a fool? He's thinking like that. So immediately one of the men was asking, well, sir, how do you like the cloth? So one of the men was asking that, did you like the cloth? Then what did the minister said? Oh, it's splendid, said the minister. So what did the minister said? Though he can't see the cloth on the loom, he said, it is splendid. Because if he say he can't see any cloth on the machine, then everyone will say that the old minister is a fool. For that reason, though he can't see a cloth on the loom, he said, yes, it is, the cloth is splendid. So I think you have understood till here. There are some hard words for you. Emperor, weavers, beautiful, special, foolish, pretend, minister, splendid, looms, clothes. So, and your home assignment is write hard words in your notebooks. Students, I have given you hard words. Write them neatly in your notes without any spelling mistakes, and also learn the spellings of the hard words. We'll be completing the remaining part of the lesson in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.